Coffee preparation is somehow an entertaining process of turning the coffee beans into a beverage. Coffee can be brewed in several different ways. The method you use to brew does make all the difference in the aroma, texture, freshness, and taste. Across our stores, you may find a range of brew methods to use for extraction. To name it accordingly, we have four types in category, such as immersion, gravity or drop method, vacuum filtration, and pressurized extraction. All these methods greatly influence your coffee. Besides, there have been so many variations to choose from for us to get our personal favorite coffee equipment, and I will make it simpler for us to understand easily. Living in the third wave of coffee industry, it is very important for us to familiarize ourselves on how each brew method operates, as this is the timeline where most consumers care about the process on how their coffee is being extracted. Now let's dive into what is commonly used for extraction. First is the pour over, that is under the category of gravity or drop method. This equipment produces coffee with a delicate and smooth texture that resides between juicy and clean cup of coffee. This equipment requires ceramic cone, a coffee server, and a paper filter to uphold the beds of coffee grounds. Next is the French press, that is under the category of immersion. In this method, coffee grounds was immersed with hot water for a period of time and strained using a metal filter that allows oils and undissolved coffee particles to pass through into the cup. A coarser grind similar to a very coarse black pepper is the required grind size upon brewing. This brewing equipment retains the flavorful oils of the coffee, resulting to a rich and full-bodied cup. The texture is quite heavier and denser than a pour-over. Brewing to a French press is straightforward and accessible to anyone who works well, particularly for people who love intense coffee. Next is the AeroPress. This method is a combination of full immersion and gentle air pressure. Similarly, it uses paper filters just like pour over. It is a plastic device, small and easy to carry, invented to brew faster than a typical drip coffee. AeroPress uses a lower water temperature and a total brew time of 2 minutes. It produces coffee with lower acidity, a concentrated espresso-style coffee, and claims a lesser bitterness on a cup. Furthermore, this equipment requires medium grind size similar to the coarseness of sea salt or number 7 in our Marconic grinder. AeroPress can work in two ways, which can be inverted type or you can directly plunge neither press on a mug. This equipment is perfect for traveler. It has a built-in features that doesn't need a coffee scale and a special kettle. It is guided with numbers for easy brewing process. Next is the Chemex, which is under the category of gravity or drop method. Chemex is a one-piece hourglass shaped vessel made with borosilicate glass fastened with a wood collar and a leather tie. This equipment is a special variation of pour over, producing a rich and clean flavorful cup of brewed coffee. It is visually attractive in appearance that requires weighing scale and a special water kettle with a long spout to start the extraction. It has also special filters calling it Chemex paper filters that perfectly fits on the equipment. Grind size for Chemex requires medium coarse grind. Last brewing equipment is the siphon. The siphon brew method is under the category of vacuum filtration. Vacuum filtration is a fast filtration technique used to separate solids from liquids. One brewing equipment we're familiar with is the siphon brewer. This method offers an entertaining and visually stunning demonstration of coffee artistry and science, brewing a coffee that is very hot, with a smooth finish and slightly cleaner taste. The siphon brew method uses immersion, vacuum pressure, and fire that requires medium grind size like table salt. To give you an idea on how this coffee apparatus works is this. Water is placed into the bottom part of the siphon machine called a glass bulb. A flame hits the water to boiling until water percolates upward to the upper part of the device called the hopper. Once the water reaches the right temperature, coffee grounds are added to hot water. After an initial stir, heat source will be then removed from the siphon. The change of force of gravity will draw the coffee down through the filter to the bulb. And now it's ready to be served. There are many other accessible brewing methods available in the market. And these are some examples we should learn to share to others. I like me better.